how does one have that switch from expectations of what love is supposed to be to actually opening themselves up to experience love that might not fit what's on paper?
There is a little bit of stardust and magic and alignment. And I think that had I met Celine, certainly in today's time when you can get information on Instagram and the like on a person, mm-hmm. you would immediately write someone off. Or had I known maybe about his brokenness or having children prior to just meeting his soul and his spirit, I may not have seen Celine. Mm-hmm. I saw, when I met him and the night that we connected, we talked until we got kicked out of a coffee shop, you know what I'm saying? And we continued to talk on the street. And we just fell in love with each other's spirit. So I think that had I known about those practical needs that we look for, mm-hmm. I may not have seen his light. Mm-hmm. You know, I may have allowed those things to shudder who he is. And mm-hmm. I'm just thankful for the magic that I am an open person and that I really just was enjoying him. And I just fell in love with him that night. And I trusted that. Mm-hmm. And he fell in love with me that night. And he trusted that. It's just as equally scary for someone in his position, because, you know, it's funny, everyone talks about, oh, Mario's dating a broke dude, but imagine finding someone you love and then they not love you because of something that really you're mm-hmm. battling from a societal norm.
Yeah.
I mean, something that is not necessarily all your fault, you know what I'm saying, or for the choices that you've made. I mean, the fact that someone like Salim or like a Yasir and like many, many others who are born in their context to make it to Los Angeles to chase a dream is beyond success. You know what I'm saying? But how are we measuring that? So I also say I'm also thankful to my mother and my grandmother and my aunt and all my family who have raised me, because they raised me to look for character. They raised me to look for that light. They didn't diminish mine, so maybe I knew how to see it. So I'm thankful that God allowed that. And I also think it's funny that God put in the package of everything I was saying 2 weeks ago, what I wasn't going to do, what he needed to be. And I really did say that. I was saying all of that. I was feeling myself.
God laughs at your plans.
Yes, right? Yes. And so gave me everything I needed and wanted in a man that I said I didn't want. So that's also that's also fun. That's also fun in the journey. It's like, okay, God, what we got?
Right.
What we
doing? What you got for me? Well, yeah.